Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm sharing my top 5 tips for how to turn a bad homeschool day around. So if you're interested in hearing more about that, then hit that thumbs up button and stay tuned. Well, for those of you who are new to my channel, welcome. My name is Sharia Maurice and I'm a homeschooling mama to 3 kiddos, ages 1, 3, and now 6 years old. And I like sharing videos on how you can simplify your homeschool to save you time, money, and your sanity. So if you enjoy that kind of thing, then be sure and hit that subscribe button, turn on the little bell icon so that you can be notified of my latest videos, and if you'd like to get a behind the scenes look at our homeschool, you can follow us over on Instagram at @TheSharaMaurice. Now, bad homeschool days. We have all had them. We often have bad homeschool days around here, and because of that, I have come up with a few ways to turn a bad homeschool day around. So I'm sharing my top 5 tips with you on how to turn around a bad homeschool day. So the first tip that I have for you is to check the main culprits of bad days, and that is usually when our kids are either tired or hungry. And so you have to consider, if you're trying to do your school day and your kids are just grumpy, they're fighting, they're not getting along, they're not listening, it could be because they didn't get enough sleep last night. And if that's the case, you might want to consider stepping it down, maybe not doing as much, adjusting the schedule to allow them to do more relaxing activities for the school day, like maybe do read alouds and stuff like that, rather than the hard mentally focused work like mathematics or something. And then the other thing would be snacks. So if they're hungry, I don't know about you, but whenever I'm hungry, I get really angry. And so that affects my attitude and my mood and all of that. And so usually a snack will turn things around. And so just give the kids some snacks and start over. That is my first tip for you. My second tip for you is to take a break and have a dance party. Yeah, there's something about stopping the academic work, putting on some music, and then just letting it loose, letting everything out, letting all the wiggles out or the bad attitudes out, something positive and uplifting and just really get you moving. It really helps my kids anyway feel better about the day. It turns the day around for us.
Tomorrow is a dance party day.
Yes, Fridays are our regular dance party days. We have Friday afternoon after school, we celebrate finishing the week with a dance party. So we always have that to look forward to. But I do that if we're just having a bad day in general. I'll pause what we're doing, throw on some music, get all the wiggles out, dance, and usually that helps turn things around. My third tip for you is to have a change of scenery. Sometimes just going through our regular school day, day after day after day, can get kind of monotonous and boring, and just it puts us in a sour mood about having to do school. And so one of the ways that can help change that attitude or that perspective about doing school is to change the scenery. You can go do math at the playground and recite your math facts at the playground while you swing. Or you could go to the library and have fun looking at books and then maybe rent out a study room, or go sit in a quiet corner at a table and do some work there. Or you could even go on a field trip. You could just forget the book work, pick everybody up and take them out to maybe a museum or some sort of planetarium or something like that. Just something to get you out of the house and at a new change of pace so that it's not the same thing day after day. And as homeschoolers, the beauty of being a homeschooler is that we have the freedom to do that, to just adjust the schedule and get out of the house. Even though it's homeschooling, doesn't mean that we have to homeschool all the time. We can school anywhere we want. Another thing you could do is to just simply go outside. Fresh air really does a body good, and I find it helpful even before we start the school day to go outside. We go on a regular morning walk, and just that alone really helps us get into the right mindset for academics. But sometimes whenever we homeschool, we find ourselves at home, usually inside, sometimes almost all day. We don't even realize that we haven't gotten outside. And so just getting into that you know, mode of let's go outside, even if it's just for 5 minutes to maybe walk around the neighborhood or toss a ball around or just go out and run around and let the kids be kids for a little while, really helps turn a bad homeschool day around. My fourth tip I have for you is to go get ice cream. Oh yeah, go get ice cream or some sort of treat. Go out of the house, go somewhere and get some sort of snack or treat. It doesn't have to be something sweet. It could be just a little snack at Chick-fil-A or something, but just to let the kids get out of the house and take a break from their studies and just enjoy being out and doing something different that breaks up the regular routine of your homeschool day. That will really help to turn things around so that by the time you get back home, they have a better attitude about things. They've had a little snack, a little treat, back to tip number one there. They've gotten out of the house. That's all of those tips combined. And then they've had the joy and fun of getting something special that they don't usually get. So I would reserve that for like those really bad days, not like your typical go-to, this is what we're gonna do, because then that takes away the fun and excitement of it. My last tip that I have for you, tip number five, is to just stop doing school. Don't try to force it for the rest of the day when everyone's moods are just in the toilet and no one is having fun with school. Just stop. Just stop doing school, call it a day, and then be done, and let them just be free from the work that is homeschool and the bookwork and the academics and all that stuff. That way you can start fresh the next day. We can always adjust our schedule to accommodate things like bad days. You could have a bad day, the kids could have a bad day, and sometimes, no matter how hard we try, all the tricks that we pull out just doesn't turn the homeschool day around. And so then the best thing to do is just stop and start over the next day. So sometimes I feel like we are so intent on, we gotta finish this lesson or we gotta finish this term out or whatever, that we really hurt ourselves worse than just stopping the day and starting over the next day. So give yourself that freedom to do that. When you plan your school year, make room for any kind of, you know, bad days that might happen. Give yourself some extra time, some margin, as some people call it, whenever they're scheduling their homeschool year and their weeks and all that stuff. Make room for those kinds of things. So that kind of is a bonus tip to tip number five. I hope that this video helped you. If you have any special tips or tricks up your sleeve on how you turn a bad homeschool day around, I would love to hear it. Leave your tip down in the comments and maybe I can get some new ideas too, because I'm always looking for ways that I can turn our homeschool day around. These five tips are what have helped me most, but I always like to hear what other homeschool moms do out there. So let me know. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Remember to subscribe and turn on that little bell icon so that you can be notified of my latest videos. And I will see you in the next one.